Poetry can cure pervasive skepticism. Know that language works. Prose for reflection, for self-fortification, to accept unrest. In quiet moments, when a ringing fills my ears, I can sense a voice. In a voice, I hear the conscious of my conscience, my intuition. The wind in trees sounds like a wave breaking on rocks in flow without ebb. Inside, I am wet with warm streams and raging seas and shifting currents. At the pool, I swim somersaults until I lose sense of direction. Look up from below and see each breath rise to break out of the bubble. Time is uneven, passing slow underwater, then fast before bed. Sunrise again, and the chorus of birdsong is nature's alarm clock. This morning stood back and waited for me to rise before breaking dawn. Footprints in wet sand, glistening sea morning light, alone on a beach. Days keep slipping past. As I try to pin them down, they avoid deadline. The sparse still wait, with branches guiding me home. In whispers I know, with indecision I close my eyes and listen. How does my heart sway? Enjoy that it is, and forget what it is, and why it is sometimes. As light breaks through clouds, announced by the crowing birds, season is changing. Branches reaching up like flames from the star called sun, a small golden orb. Ghostly melody follow me into my day, fragment of a dream. Dreamed I found a boy after the end of the world. We hid together, awoke feeling scared, dream of ghosts that make us sad in haunted houses. Me too, I might say, and can't shake those beasts from my bones, knowing not knowing. Sunlight beams through bricks, slipping through the zigzag cracks, light a crooked path. Flame embers that float high, spun into night onto smoke clouds, to dance among stars. Days are lengthening, somehow hours are shortening as time slips by, jarring dissonance between the idea and thing. It's disconcerting. Awake to birdsong, is it their chorus at dawn or restless full moon? Let's light a fire, then watch our world burn away, from ashes we'll grow. Bloom at your own pace, as courageong trees blossom every other year, losing track of time as the year crawls to an end between holidays, watching lightning fall among dust-laden raindrops, awaiting thunder. As days flutter by, they must feel like full lifetimes to a butterfly. A thick rainbow arcs over my favorite gum tree, making my morning a high water mark in the form of a pale band circling the bark.
Thank you.
A composer explained that all his tone poems and symphonic sketches had been conceived and written within a few miles of his birthplace, in one of the least populous quarters of the plains. He was trying to find the musical equivalent of the characteristic sound of his district. Strangers commented on the utter silence of the place, but the composer spoke of a subtle blend of sounds that most people habitually failed to hear. When his music was performed, the members of the orchestra were stationed far apart among the audience. Each instrument produced a volume of sound that could be heard only by the few listeners nearest it. The audience was free to move around as quietly or as noisily as they wished. Some were able to hear snatches of melody as subtle as the scraping together of grass blades or the throbbing of the brittle tissue of insects. A few even found some spot from which more than one instrument was audible. Most heard no music at all. Critics objected that no one from the audience or the orchestra could hope to hear whatever harmony might have resulted from themes that were barely stated. The composer had always maintained in public that this was just as he intended, that the purpose of his art was to draw attention to the impossibility of comprehending even such an obvious property of a plane as the sound that came from it. But in private, and especially in the hotel where I spent the last hours before my journey, the composer regretted that he would never know what his works amounted to. During each rehearsal, he wandered all over the almost empty hall, hoping, quite unreasonably he knew, to hear from somewhere a hint of the whole whose separate parts he knew so well, that he was seldom aware of any more than the trembling of a single reed or string, and he almost envied those who heard the play of the wind across miles of grass as no more than a tantalizing silence. And to me, that really does speak about how it is to be surrounded by the beauty of the Australian landscape and to find inspiration in it and yet feel somehow thwarted when looking for ways to express musically what one hears.
Thank you. yet again rose the sun in headland, behind a wall of cloud. The faces of morning smiled to see themselves going about each other's business in the front yard. Hot drinks in the gloaming upon the sofa, cloud light from the window, the computer screen at 40% brightness. An intruder auto-plays as she thumb-scrolls her device, taking silence twice and causing fluster. Together they had watched the sun sails of the little cutting whose home is the portal east, turned his face to watch the cloud light gather in the aura of tiny hairs and shine through the vein paths, and he had joked about its dumb filling of space, thinking about the commerce in repeated elements among art forms descended from advertising practices. Ah, though his sigh was no joke, as his eyes drank the details of form, idea, and watched how it differentiated itself in every aspect, made a beauty greater than most supposedly sensitive beings manage to produce other than themselves. This little fan of the sun, this little fan of the sun, this little fan of the sun, somehow reaching inside me and telling the truth, how a kind word would.